I hated to leave Barry behind, but there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnapper. This horror was everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
Thank you. This is James. Mulligan, Thornton, come in. Over.
Thornton here. James, we got both Wheeler and Rose in custody. They didn't put up a fight or anything. Why, they were... Hey, Mulligan, what are you doing? Come on!
Sit down and give me that. James, Mulligan here. Over.
Go ahead, Mulligan. Over.
We got Wheeler and Rose here. Wheeler's drunk or hopped up on something. Speaking of which, that Fed had a pretty distinctive whiff of eau de scotch about him, you know what I mean. Over.
I don't have anything on that, Deputy Mulligan. Over.
Well, whatever. Anyway, Rose is just being plain weird here. You better get Doc in to take a look at both. Over.
Gotcha. You better get them here quickly. The, Fed's gonna wanna interview Wheeler. Over.
Oh, yeah, I bet he does. Looks like they have a lot in common. Mulligan out.
I could see the lights at the radio station in the distance. I imagined that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Maine seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine. Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't get through without a light. It took me a moment to recognize the flashbang grenades. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
One, come in. Over. Team One, this is Sheriff Breaker. Report. Over. Team Two, come in. I need a report. Over. Come on, guys. Talk to me. Come in, please. Over.
Silent! another call. You're on KBFFM with Pat Maine.
It's Milt Peabody, Pat.
What's on your mind, Milt?
Well, I live near the trailer park, Pat, and there's a big ruckus going on over there.
Well, that's just up the road from me, too. What's going on, do you know?
I don't know, but there's a bunch of police cars there, lots of sirens, a helicopter buzzing around, and I think I heard some gunshots.
Gunshots?
Yes, sir, like from a pistol. So can you find out what's going on? Because it's just next door, and they're popping off guns there.
They're still shooting?
No, it was maybe 10, 15 minutes ago. It sounds serious, Pat. I'm telling you, it don't sound like no party.
Well, I'm certainly going to give the station a call, Milt.
Okay.
You'll hear it here as soon as I hear from them.
Okay, thanks.
I hope Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
Pat, it's Lorna Miles.
Why, hello, Lorna. What do you have for us?
Well, I just don't see why the cops bothered with the trailer park.
What do you...
Like that? I mean, what do you expect?
surprise. The famous writer Alan Wake just walked in. Folks, I'm going to see if I can talk him into an interview.
Come on in, Mr. Wake.
Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere to run now, Dan Brown. You back away from me. Don't hurt.
Whoa. Everyone calm down. Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him.
Dude, freak!
What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.